Hello and welcome to APM Research Operation Ptolemy. Operation Ptolemy is a simple observation and experiment you can try for yourself. Ptolemy's model reigned supreme for around 1600 years, until the Copernican model arrived around the 1600s reset event. Now Ptolemy's model contained epicycle motions of certain luminaries, or planets, the Sun and the Moon. If you take a look at this animation, this is how some people think the Sun moves, and that is mainly due to what the Sun appears to be doing when time-lapsed. It appears to make a corkscrew motion, but this is incorrect. We have featured these epicycles in older works, and Sandra captured it here in this video. It is the rotation of the halo that the Sun is a part of that is creating these epicycle motions. The Sun just follows it as it is part of that configuration. This is what their chem planes are trying to hide by dried up moisture and ice crystals in the atmosphere and interfering with their precipitation processes. We have come to find that the Sun, water droplets and ice crystals actually help reveal electromagnetics on a scale that can only match what is described in holy books and creation stories, when decoded correctly. To capture the Sun epicycling, simply record it or time-lapse it for around 1 hour. When reviewing your recording, put a line through the centre of the Sun at the start of the recording and a line through its centre at the end of the recording, so it shows you the Sun's path. When you play this video, it should reveal its epicycle motions. Now, a lot of people seem to think the Ptolemaic model relates to a circular map, but it does not. It is not a great circle it is referring to. If you listen to certain holy books or the Book of Enoch, it's a great circuit, and the circuit that it's referring to is the circuit you see in our grid. The great circuit. It's referenced in, I'm sure it's in the Book of Enoch. It is the largest concentric circles you see on the grid we are using. These are blueprints I decoded from the Nazca lines that match Enoch's descriptions of the portals, which are gates in the north, south, east and west, and also their angles in relation to one another. This grid is a blueprint of the construct, and the Nazca lines are schematics of various technologies that are in the underworld, which is also referenced throughout our history in many forms and depictions, often personified or using species of creatures. And on screen, what you're seeing is, you know, these epicycle motions. This would be it coming towards you, and you would capture that kind of motion, which does look like a corkscrew. But when you look at the motion of the halo, the Sun is attached to, the Sun's got no choice but to follow its motion. So the halo is actually epicycling below ground, and we're seeing what's taking place in the sky. This is, you know, the Sun halo, ice crystals, it reveal all this. And this would be a top-down view studying it. So depending on your angle, you're going to get different aspects of these epicycle motions showing. These are just some samples to show you what you would expect to see. Not that I'm expecting any of you to be above it looking down, but this is what you would expect to see, these kind of motions. Now, obviously, this is not to scale either, but this is, you know, this is what you would actually see them doing across here. And the reason I've got this on screen at the moment is because I'm also going to show you our solar eclipse. Because now you can see that the Sun's in a higher layer than the Moon. We're going to get into the solar eclipse, which I've never released before because I was still studying it in between doing other research. But that there is just to show you one is above the other, and this is what's takes place of a solar eclipse. Now if you see these two epicycling across the sky like this, this is what's really taking place with them. And if you look at the eclipse images at the bottom there, you can see all these curved lines, those curve, and this is why, because they've got their own paths that they have to follow. If you look on the screen, you'll see the eclipse in there, but take it from me, anytime these two are in the sky, there is eclipses every day. You're just not in the right place to see it. But these will eclipse every day they're both in the sky. We're going to go a bit deeper on that as well with Rahu and Ketu. In fact, I'll bring that into it now because you watch that, what's taking place there. So this animation's to show you what's taking place with these eclipses. So this is the solar eclipse. So this obviously the sun's higher up in the layers. This is a top-down view, and you can see how the moon would eclipse it and cause these curved paths that they follow. You can actually see this on some eclipses as well. If you watch the shadows on the eclipses, you'll see them coming in from one angle and leaving from a completely different angle. Well, that angle change is these epicycle motions you're actually seeing in the shadows. Now, on the subject of Rahu and Ketu, you know from our research now, the small halo being Adam is the head, and the large halo is Eve. So that's the head and the body. Both of these two create electromagnetism. Now, this technology, you can switch the head off and the body. As we mentioned in older decodes, there is off switches that will switch the sun off and the halo. So as the sun crosses the sky, sir, we see the sun halo, but when it returns back, the sun is shut down. So they switched off the head or cut off the head, but we're still seeing the part of the body that is part of that projection system. I use the word projection lightly because it's not really a projection. It does have a physical presence in the atmosphere. It's just elevated there because of magnetism and electricity being in opposition. Very clever science. It's not that hard to understand it once you study it.